The CalDigit TS5 is finally here, and this features Thunderbolt 5 technology, which doubled the bandwidth of Thunderbolt 4, going all the way from 40 gigabits a second of bandwidth to 80, and it even supports the 120 gigabit a second bandwidth boost for use with external displays. So in this video, we're going to look at the TS5, talk about all the things I like about it, a couple issues I have with it, and also talk about when you should maybe consider CalDigit's Element 5 or their TS5 Plus or other Thunderbolt 5 docking stations instead. I do want to say CalDigit sent me this docking station for free for purposes of making this video. They've got no input in this content. This is based on my experience using this, who I think it's for, and who I think should look elsewhere. Docking stations are great because you can take one cable, plug it into your computer, and then you can have displays, fast external SSDs, or really any other computer peripherals all plugged in at the same time while powering your computer. And now that Thunderbolt 5 technology is here, we can support more bandwidth than ever before, which leads to less bottleneck issues. So with Thunderbolt 4 docks, you could run into issues if you were running external SSDs and displays that were taking a lot of bandwidth, but Thunderbolt 5 now goes all the way up to 120 gigabits a second of bandwidth, which is amazing because it gives you that extra wiggle room for things like the Apple Studio display or other Thunderbolt-based displays. CalDigit is known for making some of the most reliable Thunderbolt docks, and the TS5 really gives you everything that you need to get your setup running. On the back, you have your Thunderbolt downstream port, which makes your desktop setup look really clean, and they give you a nice braided Thunderbolt 5 cable in the box. You get up to 140 watts of power going to your computer to keep it charged and running, so even if you got a 16-inch MacBook Pro, there's plenty of power. And then there's three more Thunderbolt downstream ports, two USB 3 data ports, one of them is Type-C and one of them is Type-A, an additional USB 2 port, USB-A. You also get a headphone jack and a microphone input on the back, as well as a 2.5 gigabit network port. And then on the front of it, you get a 20-watt USB-C port, a standard 7.5-watt USB-C port, then UHS 2 SD and micro SD card slot, as well as a headset jack as well. CalDigit's design is cool because they actually give you these little removable rubber feet, so you can either run it laying down flat like this, or you can also run it vertically depending on what your setup calls for. The TS5 supports up to dual monitors with a Mac computer, and with Windows computers, you can go all the way up to three displays. But depending on the Mac computer you have, you may be limited to one external display. This is technically a Thunderbolt 5 dock, but it'll also be fully backwards compatible with Thunderbolt 3 and Thunderbolt 4 computers. It also works with some forms of USB as well, but the port on your device will determine the speeds that you can expect to get out of this. So in the box, you get the docking station, the nice braided Thunderbolt 5 cable, and the 240 watt power adapter. What's great about the high capacity power adapter is you have up to 140 watts of power for your computer or your iPad or whatever you're plugging this into to host it. And then all the USB-C ports and the USB-A ports get 7.5 watts, plus one of the front USB-C ports also supports 20 watts of charging. And then the Thunderbolt ports on the back all get 15 watts of power each. So even if you're using power-hungry devices, this is gonna have plenty of power for you. There's really only a couple small downsides to this though. First, I think the 2.5 gigabit port should have been a 10 gig port, mainly because we're seeing more faster network equipment than ever. And it would definitely be a letdown to have to use one of your Thunderbolt ports on the back for a 10 gig adapter. That just kind of defeats the purpose of having a dock. Another thing that I do wish was different is I wish that that USB 2 port was USB 3. For me, I just use this with audio interfaces and MIDI devices, and that's just fine for my setup, but I do find that to be a little bit limiting. One other thing I would have loved to see them change is only have one USB-C port on the front of it and to put the other one on the back of it, because for my setup, I wish I had one more on the back of it. I can run a cable around to the front. It's just not as clean looking. And then another thing I would maybe change is I would like to see one of the additional Thunderbolt downstream ports being on the front instead. That way you could easily plug Thunderbolt drives into the front. As it stands, the USB-C ports on the front will top out at the slower 10 gigabit a second speeds, which is okay for most people. But if you're like me and you've got those fast SSDs that you like to use, it's a little bit of an inconvenience to reach around and plug it into the back of it. One other small con is there's no dedicated video output on this. CalDigit does say you need to use one of the Thunderbolt ports with an adapter if you're going to HDMI or DisplayPort. For the studio display, it worked just fine, and I also was able to plug my LG Dual up using the USB-C cable into the back with one of the Thunderbolt ports on it, and that worked just fine as well. But depending on your setup, you may find it a little bit of an inconvenience to have to run an HDMI or DisplayPort dongle on the back of it. Really, the only other con to the TS5 is the price. It does come in at $400, which is definitely a premium, and you're really paying for CalDigit's great reputation, reliability, and support that you're gonna get by buying this. Also, compared to some of the other docks, like the Sonnet one with the built-in SSD, the Razer dock with the built-in SSD, there's really no killer feature with the CalDigit TS5 other than just being super reliable and having a very beefy power brick that reserves plenty of power for all the ports. I found the USB-C ports on this and all the Thunderbolt ports Never had any issues with keeping up with even my fastest external devices. CalDigit also has two other Thunderbolt 5 devices. There's the Element 5, which is really more of a hub, but this one still gives you 90 watts of power for your computer, has a couple USB ports, some more Thunderbolt ports, and gives you a lot of versatility in a small package. And they also have the TS5 Plus, which is really beefy. It's bigger than the TS5, but only by a little bit, but it gives you way more USB ports on the back of it. And it also adds a DisplayPort. It also gives you a 10 gig Ethernet port, and it gives you more powerful Thunderbolt ports, but it does take one of the Thunderbolt ports away. It also has a 330 watt power adapter versus the 240 watt that comes with the standard TS5. I found for me, the TS5 Plus was a little bit better of a fit just because I needed more USB ports to keep all my different musical equipment plugged in. But I was also able to make the TS5 work just fine just by being a little bit more creative with the port placement and also taking advantage of the ports on the front of it. The TS5 Plus also is $100 more expensive than the TS5. So really, you just need to take a look at all the ports, look at your setup, and decide which one's going to be a better option for you. So overall, the TS5 is a great, reliable, high-power, high-bandwidth Thunderbolt 5 dock that gives you plenty of ports on it. You may find for your setup, you need a couple more USB ports, in which case I would say go ahead and get the TS5 Plus. That one will give you even more power and give you a couple faster ports. But if you're using more Thunderbolt-based devices, then this one will do just fine for you. And of course, you can also always add another USB hub on the back of it. That definitely kind of defeats the purpose of having everything in one nice docking station. But even with a couple of the quirks of not having as many USB ports on the back of it, I found the TS5 still gave me plenty of power and plenty of connectivity to keep my whole desktop setup running. If you're interested in buying the TS5, I do have links to buy in the description below. If you got any other questions about this or think I missed anything, leave a comment down below. I'd love to hear them. Like this video, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any upcoming content.